showered, taken a bath, brushed our teeth, and all of that. And I tell you, you all turned up very, very. Thank you for coming. I want to welcome you to our 15th annual Martin Luther King Unity Breakfast. Brother James Upshaw and Brother J.J. Johnson III are especially proud of this one, as evidenced in part by the back cover of your program, which, by the way, was designed by a Gamma Phi brother, Brother James McClain, who is an architect major here at Tuskegee University. It lists the previous 14 speakers with an exclamation point provided by our speaker today, the Reverend, the illustrious Brother Reverend Dr. Edward L. Wheeler. We were in a meeting the other night, and I mentioned to the group that it just doesn't feel like 15 years. Brother Upshaw quickly pointed out that that's not true. It does feel like 15 years. Because he and Brother Johnson have been primarily responsible for all of it. But now, this is the first time in 15 years that I have not been able to preface this program this morning by making reference to, more often than not, a Tuskegee University victory over Alabama State in the Turkey Day Classic. So I guess this morning I need to instead offer my condolences and my most sincere condolences to all of you Patriot and 49ers fans. We have an outstanding program prepared for you today. It is certainly representative of the 15th anniversary. Now, we will soon hear more about our illustrious speaker from Brother Warren Duncan. But let me call your attention to the program, and on that program it says Music Fellowship. Well, Brother Howell, where's Brother Howell? Brother Howell, who is responsible for the audio and video that you see here, has assured me that he has much more in store for us than just Music Fellowship. So without further ado, let us call this program to order, and let us begin with the Unity Prayer, which will be offered by Brother Benjamin Outland, who is our chaplain.
Brother Outland. Good morning.
Good morning.
Let's bow our heads in prayer. This is a prayer of unity in Heavenly Father. We thank thee that whatever desires to come, or whoever desires to become great among you, shall be your servants. We thank you for this concept from the Bible, Mark 10, 43. In 1968, Martin Luther King Jr. said that everybody can be great because everybody can serve. And we thank you, Heavenly Father, that we can serve. A college degree is not necessary in order to serve. Of course, it certainly will help. Agreements on subjects and verbs then are very important. It's important that we don't have to know about Plato and Aristotle in order to thank the Lord. Your only need is a heart full of grace. And to say this, also full of love. If we are willing to be a servant, that will all of us, whoever we are, we let things done in Christ's name be great things. Keep us, Lord, to do whatever that thou desires for us to do. Guide our hearts and our minds and our souls. Help us, because of the Father. When we open our ears to hear, speak it today, help us do servants of all mankind. Bless us and direct us in this program, and give us unity as we go forth to serve. In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and by his sake we pray. Amen.
And now, I will turn your attention to the aforementioned Brother Reginald Howe. Brother Howe. Tuskegee Institute, majoring in sociology, Reverend Shepherd.
As the psalmist says, my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus and his righteousness. With that in mind, let us go to the throne of mercy. Most gracious Heavenly Father, we come this morning knowing that you and you alone are worthy to be praised. We come this morning understanding that hope leads to righteousness. We know that hope is what we have, Lord, because we know that it's a difficult time and a difficult road that we are on. But our journey, though fraught with peril, we understand, Lord, that you said, in this world you will have trials and tribulations. But take heart, I've already overcome the world. And we hope and we understand, Lord, that as we live our lives, as we go about our daily chores and live in the jobs that we have, we know that our hope is based on a solid foundation. We hope, Lord, that you will be with the president as he tries to lead this country. We have hope, Lord, that those that stand against him will understand that you and you alone are in charge. We have hope, Lord, that our universities, our colleges will turn out young men and young women that will stay on the battlefield for you, Lord. We have hope, Lord, that we will just continue to be people of God, understanding and knowing that just like this proud fraternity continues to serve you. One of their very own, Dr. Martin Luther King, Lord, served to the full measure of his life, never lost hope and never lost faith. He knew, Lord, that the struggle would be long, and as it continues, we see the day of light. We continue to struggle, we continue to work, we stay on the battlefield because we know that you and you alone are there leading and guiding. We ask, Lord, that you receive this prayer from your humble servant. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Shepherd. I'd like to point out that he did that without a prepared text. Next on the itinerary today is the litany and the lighting of the unity candle. That ceremony will be handled by our own brother Eric Marsh Jr., who is the president of Gamma Phi Chapter here at Tuskegee University. And I might point out that Gamma Phi Chapter was in attendance at our recent district conference, wherein 10 prestigious awards are given out for various things. I want you to know that Gamma Phi Chapter under Brother Mark's leadership won 9 of those. Brother Mark's.
We remember the criticism Brother King received from a community of clergy for his involvement in the struggle for justice in Birmingham, and the love and patience of his warm response from the Birmingham City Jail.
We commit ourselves to love those who have not yet accepted their responsibility to participate in the struggle, as much as we embrace those who have joined us in the struggle.
We remember Brother King's acknowledgement that there comes a time when the cup of endurance runs over and men are no longer willing to be plunged into the abyss of despair.
We pray that our hearts will never resort to bitterness, despite having lost along the road to freedom.
We remember the conviction of Martin Luther King Jr. that freedom is never voluntarily given by the oppressor, but it is demanded by the oppressed.
We pray for courage and determination for those who are oppressed, including among them ourselves.
We remember Martin's warning that a negative peace, which is the absence of tension, is less than a positive peace, which is the presence of justice.
We pray for those who work for peace in our world.
We remember Martin's insight that injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere.
We pray that peace is not in isolation, but no
remember Martin's observation that the contemporary church is often a weak, ineffectual voice with an uncertain sound.
We pray that we will never be silent in the face of wrong.
We remember Martin's hope that dark clouds of racial prejudice will soon pass away and the deep fog of misunderstanding will be lifted. And in the not too distant tomorrow, the radiant stars of love and brotherhood will shine over our great nation with all their scintillating beauty.
Therefore, in faith, we offer our work and ourselves as justice to the good vision of Almighty God.
All together,
God, our peace, we hear your call. We experience your ministry in our lives of peacemakers and justice seekers. We thank you for the power of witnesses.
Right behind Brother Bray.
Because they're going to start with the table.
Brother Reginald Howell, we've already University, but not into the fraternity. Brother Lucisi, and I've got to mention, in his absence, Brother J.J. Johnson, III. The dance group that you saw earlier is the Golden Essence Dance Team, direction of Brother Howell's wife, Marie Howell. All right, now we'll get back to the program. The introduction of the Unity Speaker. You know, you hear the phrase a lot of times, he needs no introduction, and in this instance, that is the case. However, we will have an introduction of our speaker. And doing that this morning on behalf of the chapter will be Brother Warren Duncan. Brother Duncan is originally from Jacksonville, Florida. He is a graduate of Florida A&M University. And we all know him as the director of the nationally renowned Tuskegee University Marching Band. And he has held that position now for over 40 years. You know, there are some that attribute that long-standing tenure to his outstanding ability. And there are some that say that he has to stay here until he gets it right. I attribute it to his ability to direct the nationally renowned Tuskegee University Marching Band, Brother Warren L. Duncan.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you, Brother Robert L. Davis. It gives me a privilege to introduce our other brother, Reverend Edward L. Hill. If there's anybody in this room who can tell me what the three L's mean, his L, my L, and his L, I got a prize for you. I may be the only one in the room that can do that, all three. But let's see. See me afterwards. First of all, let me thank, I think, my brothers for allowing me to introduce our speaker for today. But Brother Upshaw, now hear this. Next time, let me know I'm going to do this before I give you the bow. I know what to say. You put it all in here. And I can't read it to everybody in this room because everybody can read. And I insist for my students not to present me a report. Put it on the wall and it's all presented in and read it to me. So I wouldn't insult your intelligence by doing that. However, I'm going to highlight some things that are on the program. But just to say a few things quickly, in waiting for the word to come to me, and Brother Goody, you profoundly gave me that instinct years ago. You know, when I seek counsel from you. And many of us maybe have had some counseling sessions. I won't ask you to raise your hands. But I was offered some jobs some years ago, and I went to talk with the dean about